This is Nu-Trix the Synth Guy, and I'm answering again another question from a subscriber. It's part of our, you know, list of quick tips on how to use the different Roland boutiques. Today we're talking about the TR-09, but what I'm talking about with the TR-09 is something that can be mostly used with all the other boutiques, and we'll actually test them out separately to see if there's any little differences, but the big picture should be the same. How do you use the audio over USB between the TR-09 and Ableton Live, for example? The main question is, how do you set up everything? And what exactly can you do with it? Depending on the device you have, they don't have the same amount of ins and outs, so it changes a little bit, but the logic is the same. In the case of the TR-09, when you hook it up to the computer, it appears 10 inputs over USB, and you have two outputs. So the concept is interesting because when you look at how the TR-09 works with the Mac or a PC, what you have is that basically it appears as an audio interface over USB, and it also appears as, all right. It appears as an audio interface over USB and also as a MIDI interface over USB. So it can send and receive MIDI depending on the device, and it can also send and receive audio. Today we'll talk about the TR-09, and sadly, when I got the question from a user, I was looking around trying to figure out how to do it myself. And I remember I did it, but I did it as just as to check how it worked. And I never really used it for my own recording, because what I do now is most of my album, I do them on the iPad. So I'll talk about it later on another video how I do that. But so I don't really use the audio over USB in my case. So I did start to practice and figure out how it was. And there's some stuff I was expecting to be able to do and did not happen the way I expected. And I actually wrote to Roland to see if there's any, you know, other ways that I'm wishing that it would exist but does not, or I'm just doing something wrong. So the first thing you need to understand is, for any Roland boutiques or any type of device that hooks up to the computer, the most stable way to use it is to actually turn it off before you connect anything, and then you connect the USB into the device when it's off. You connect the cable into your computer when it's off, and then you turn it on. And that's the best way for it to know it's connected to the computer and switched into the, you know, audio interface or MIDI interface mode, and your computer goes, okay, I've got an interface. That's the best way to do it. If you turn it on, then you plug it in, it could not work as well. It depends on how it was programmed. It depends on the driver. Of course, for this to work, you need to install the drivers from Roland website. So you go on Roland website, you look for the TR-09, and there's a section called download, and you download the drivers. There's different ones. There's of course Windows and Mac. And Mac, there's like two versions depending on the OS you have. So check out, verify that you have the right driver for your OS. And by the way, you should upgrade your TR-09 to the latest firmware if it hasn't been done. Now, the latest firmware will give you stuff like panning and other things. So check that out. I'll do another video on firmware update and backups. How to backup the memory of the TR-09 coming soon. Okay, so when this is done, now normally your computer sees this as an interface. So I will actually start recording this so you can actually see what I'm doing. Before using your DAW, you should go and look into what they call the MIDI configuration and audio configuration. So I've got these little two screens. Now they're in French because I'm French Canadian. You get the MIDI and you want to see audio. So you get this audio, you got the interface here, the internal and the TR-09. You can say, I want to use this for recording for the Mac. Entry and input and outputs. Okay, you've got 10 inputs and two outputs. 10. So that's a good news. We'll see. And output. So it means that basically you could actually move around with your computer and this becomes your sound card. So you could actually put your headphones into the back of this, and when you press play and live, you would hear the whole session playing through the TR-09, because that's not just playing the internal sound, but also playing back what's come from computer, because it's an interface. It's a sound card. It's your interface. And there's 10 inputs going into. So we imagine 10 sounds could be separately sent to this. I'm saying imagine because for now, it's not exactly what I want. So that's done. And in the MIDI part, well, you should see somewhere as an interface, the TR-09 saying it's there as a MIDI interface. I actually use it. I can send and receive MIDI from, which is really important for the part where you want the two devices to run in sync. When you want to press play on live and you want the TR-09 to follow, well, first you want it to start at the right moment and you want it to follow the same speed. And when you stop, you want it to stop. So that's going to be MIDI sync through USB. Okay, so let's now turn on live. In live, you go into preferences, you go check out that your audio device is really the TR-09 as the input, and the output, right now I'm going to keep it to the Mac output, because what I want to do is be able to hear it, I want you to be able to hear it also when I record, so I'm going to keep it on sortie intégrée, which means integrated outputs from the Mac. Okay, so this is done. I just have selected these. I can say input config. I like to put them in mono. You can activate stereo also if you want. Doesn't matter. I'll copy the mono most of them for now. So I'm going to delete my two MIDI tracks for now. I don't want them. And I'm going to have Command-T MIDI inputs. Okay, MIDI in. So I'm going to go press play. So I can have something that starts. Let's select a pattern. Okay, so I don't even know what I'm hearing. I'm gonna go 3 and put it the input. Okay, I've got something coming in. If I go the other one here, 4, I've got the same thing. So 3 and 4 are a copy of the same. 5, I've got the tums, I go 6, actually if I select, let's go back to configure, and let's say I want to have all of them in stereo to see what it sounds like. If I go back here and say this one is 5, 6, I've got all my tums here. And I would have 7 and 8 and 9 and 10. I'm gonna go input. Right now, it's even better to be in stereo. So the best way to do it, I'm going to stop it now. You see, it also synced. Now, the reason, many things. First of all, to send the sound to 1, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, or 9, or 10, you have to go into the menu. And in the menu, you select USB, and then there's USB 1, 2, 3, and 4. Now, if you had USB 1, the instruments you pressed on and they start flashing, you're saying to the TR-09 that these will be sent to USB 1, which equals to the computer the input 3 and 4. So USB 1 equals 3 and 4, USB 2 equals 5 and 6, USB 3 equals 7 and 8, and USB 4 equals 9 and 10. Now, I was trying to pan them left and right to say, well, 3, so USB 1, pan on one side would be the kick, and USB 1 pan on the other side would be the snare. Not able to do it. You know, I can pan, and the analog output at the back, I can hear their pan left and right, but over USB, it does not translate. So I wrote to Roland to see if there's anything I can do, if there's anything I'm not doing well for it to work this way, but I would expect it to work this way, because it would give us separate outputs for all of our sounds. Now, when this is done, right now I can actually use it as a multiple inputs, but in stereo, still it would work. So I would have kick and, let's say, kick and snare on one, one in, or, you know, there's a different way. If I use it only this way, maybe I would say in USB 1, it would be the kick, USB 2 would be the snare, USB 3 would be the toms, and USB 4 would be all the, you know, cymbals and hi-hats. So it would be kind of separating them depending on what type of sounds I'm using. So that would be kind of, you decide how you want to do them, but just, and if you want to use more, you also have the output that still works at the same time. Now, there's still my question I have here. If I actually, if I want to sync it, because I press like this, it starts at the right moment. So this goes, you have to go into preferences, you have to go into MIDI, and in MIDI, there's two sections. There's a top section when you select the interface MIDI control surface and all that that you have, and the bottom, you've got MIDI ports. In this case, I only have this connected. So I have the TR-09, and I've got the track, the sync, and the remote. Now, in this case, I want to use input and output. I'm turning them all on, so it's sending the MIDI sync, it's sending, and it's probably sending too much stuff that I don't actually need, because there's no, well, MIDI clock, it's good. SMT doesn't really care. The MTC doesn't matter, it doesn't use it, but MIDI sync, MIDI clock works. And you want, you know, the two-way messages, either going to it or coming from it, because if I press start here, I want live to start also. But if I want live to start, it would have to be in sync mode. So I would have to go into, oh, external. You have to press here, external. So now if I press, see, now it follows. Now it follows at the top here. If I press stop, it stops. So, and it works in the other way around. Oh no, because now it's in sync, it won't follow. Oh, sorry. Yeah. Where does that shh coming from? This computer is going really hot. You can hear it through the microphone. MIDI works, and then you go, okay, I've got the input 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. What is the 1 and 2 for? I don't know. I have no clue. So yesterday I was writing to Roland and say, okay, what are the 1 and 2 for? So I'm waiting to answer, but I know we're close to Christmas, so I'm not sure they're going to answer, you know. I like the people from Roland, but they also have a family life. I have an idea. I'm just guessing it might be the mix in that can be used as an input. So I'll test something. I've got this here, okay. I've got the SC2 here. Another, you know, little, marvelous little piece of gear from Roland. And I'm gonna take a cable. I'm doing this live, just a hinge I had yesterday while writing at, you know, midnight to Roland and say, hey, would it be, you know, what's the logic of this mixed, you know, input? So I'm gonna take the output of the SC02, put into the mix in. Where's the mix in? Mix in here, okay. So, if I don't. So there's sound coming out of this, so it works. If I want to use this with this, now let's go see if I select. Yes! It's coming into the 1 and 2. Oh, this is cool. So 1 and 2 means that this becomes also an interface that can convert anything coming in right into your computer. So it becomes your sound card. This is really cool. Now, I'm too loud. I'm too loud. Oh, this is so nice. So yes, you've got two inputs from the mix in that becomes a sound card. Send it to the computer, and you've got 8 other inputs that are basically playback off this. You should, for now, look at them as 4 stereo send that don't seem to accept panning, so for there has to be a way to do it. If you know how to do it, please write me in the comments below or write me directly. I want to know how to pan them because it becomes really interesting. But this, the fact that this becomes an input means that you can basically bring this with your computer, this, and I expect the other device to do the same, because they mostly, all of them have mixed in. It means that all of them can become a sound card. So it becomes a really, really cool portable device. You take this with your computer, it's your sound interface, your audio interface right there. I like this. You know, that's the kind of thing that Roland does that, I mean, they do great things, but they don't talk about it. I remember having, you know, a bunch of, you know, I had a SH32 at one point from Roland, and it sounded great. It was a great sounding synth, a lot of power, but everything was in sub menus, and you had to press two knobs to get into this. And unless you knew somebody from Roland to say, this is how you do it, like, it was impossible to really get the most out of the device. So I got rid of it because I was like, no, I'm always finding or trying to figure out how it works. But this is, I mean, this is a nice little news that I just found for myself today. I'm really happy about that. This is how you do it. First, download the driver, connect the USB, turn it on, then turn on your software. You should see it in the list, select. And if you want to send to separate outputs, you go into menu. There's USB 1, USB 2, USB 3, USB 4. For now, see them as four stereo outputs. I'm still looking to find how to pan them. If we are able to pan them, you'll be able to get eight individual mono inputs. And on top, you've got the 1 and 2, which is basically what's coming into the mix in. So this becomes a sound card. You can hook up anything you want. Like, I would actually bring my iPad, plug my iPad here, and it's a way to get my sound right into the computer while I'm having my iPad sync to my computer. I like that idea. It becomes a really portable system you just walk around with. I'm just get this idea here. This one has no mix in. That's my problem. So the one I own, that's mine. This one has gate out and gate and CV out. Then there's phone. There's no mix in. So this is just a MIDI interface, Bluetooth MIDI interface. That's the only one who has Bluetooth. I don't know why the others don't. They should. That's it, guys. I hope this is useful. Again, write to me. If one person, any of you, know how to use this with panning over USB, I want to know how to do this. I really want to know how to do this. That's it. Again, if you like what I'm doing, thumb up. If you don't, suggest other things that you would like to see. And follow me on my Facebook. And there's a link somewhere here. Also, I've got my Nu-Trix.com website you can look in. And hey, take the time to listen to what I'm doing musically. There's a link somewhere here. Cheers, guys, and happy holidays.